Making a life worth living and retirement worth having is about helping people to move forward in life after many challenges and many struggles and many triumphs and all the aspects that life brings to our lives. Practically, we all go through ups, downs, ins, outs, turns, twists, and turnabouts, and that is really what the life force is like. We are put in lessons of our life. We are struggling through nothing, in truth. It's all about attitude, some professionals say, while others say no, it's a mental state in other realms. But in reality, what does the Lord really think of our life? Have most pastors really thought about how they stand in front of the Lord in their own way? You see, pastors often preach from the pulpit that life is about God. Well, how is life about God if we're not talking about how to see the signs of God and literally how to recognize the signage that point us in the right directions towards literally the right people? I literally have someone who's blamed me for things that I don't know anything about, and I sit there and I wonder, how does she literally think that? How possibly could she think that when we haven't really talked in a long time? And practically, I have other people in my birth family who think they have done things lawfully when they've actually practically done things illegally. But how do you prove that? You see, my siblings think as long as I can't prove something, that doesn't mean it didn't happen, and that's not the truth of the law. What I find absolutely, practically, somewhat ghastly is that in Indiana we are not allowed to apparently have smoked license plates to give us some privacy to our license plates, and yet the sheriff of Hamilton County are all starting to have them on their plates. Why is that? Why do they get to be in disguise, rolling through the communities, getting onto internets, getting onto our computers when we're in public Wi-Fi areas? And practically, why do they get the incognito-ness of a Robin Hood, when in reality, are they stealing from the rich and giving to the poor, or are they simply taking from the poor and making themselves rich? Now, literally, if I talk about this in a way that makes sense to a television and movie-oriented world, it's a great movie idea. Practically, that there might be someone out there who's tired of all the lies we get told about where our rights begin and where other people's rights end, and openly, that is the truth. That my rights online in a public place remain with me. Your rights online in another public place or the same public place stay with you. When you start to cross over into the other people's literal rights, like what happened to me in a Starbucks at a Barnes & Noble in the middle of the Noblesville area, an Indian couple was there flirting and carrying on in ways that was sort of sweet but also sort of sickening at the same time, being an old man. But practically, all of a sudden, a good percentage of my videos started to seem to appear, to really disappear off one of my channels. Now, does that mean that the technologists from the third world countries are starting to infiltrate our community because they come in with wealth and affluence and literally maybe oil barons' children that get here through school scholarship and scholastic abilities that put them above the cream of the crop in their country so they're allowed in here on special statuses? I don't really know. I don't really know how the immigration practices work for every country and every nation, because what I literally know from my own life experience of participating in that and bringing some important friends of my life over to America was we had to follow the rules that related specific to that country issue. And when we provided all the legal documentation, all the right financial information, all the right supportive information, literally from my father, everything worked out just fine. That was lawfully handled in a legal way, and practically, my name was participating in that the way that I was supposed to, lawfully and legally, in that moment of time. You see, in moments of time, we can have different laws that apply to us. We can also have different legalities that apply to us, too. Liability is not something that people really think about a great deal today. They don't really think about how hard it is to not be liable for a comment they made, a practical gossip point they've shared, or literally how they represent an organization in every single moment in time in which they are on the premises employed as a representative of that organization. I've been coming regularly to one of the McDonald's in the community because, A, I like the fact that I can sit there and no one hassles me about sitting down, and God forbid I fall asleep out of my fatigue, no one messes with my belongings like in other places, at least as far as I can tell. The staff is very regardful, they are very kind, they are very loving in a way, very hospitable in another way, and a lot of fun to watch in their interactions with one another. They seem to love on each other, seem to hassle each other, they seem to celebrate one another, and they seem to do it with a style and flair that is unique to this diverse group of people. There are whites, there are blacks, there are children with special needs, and I call them children because their moms and dads still bring them to work, and that's the way it is in life. But practically what's impressive is how each individual works so hard to do their little job. I've seen a young man who's superb. He literally will climb on a ladder outside the restaurant in the freezing cold and take a cling, which I hate on these windows, off the window without scratching a thing, without ruining the cling, and it's impressive. I watched him help one of the special needs oriented managers, and I mean that politely. She's just a little delayed, not significantly delayed. And he literally said, "Here, let me take care of that for you." And he stepped in like any good old man would do, and he's probably in his 20s, and he did his job. I've seen him take the trash out with precision, without any difficulty, without complaint, and that is a rarity in this world. Young men and women like this should be lauded, applauded, celebrated, and promoted. And openly, they've got a litany of managers at this place, and maybe they just all take turns so they all have a life worth living and a retirement worth having, or maybe this is a training facility for a handful of managers who are coming in and out. I can't say. What I know is that the restaurant is clean, that the staff is pretty well versed in its product, and that for the most part, it's a super little place to be. It's quiet during the day. They don't hassle you if you sit. They don't care if you eat three meals a day there, as long as you're not interfering with other patrons. And frankly, that's the way it should be in life. Practically, this customer service that I've been experiencing at this little shop here in the Noblesville area is outstanding. They really deserve all the accolades in the world for what they do here. Wouldn't it be wonderful if every person in their job took it upon themselves to get to know their other teammates well enough to really just love and celebrate who they are as individuals? If we did that more in the world, wouldn't more people be at peace in their lives? Wouldn't more poverty be stricken from the earth? And wouldn't we openly have the opportunities to help others who are truly in need? You see, the only way to help someone in need is to literally say, "What do you need from me right now that I can do?" You see, sometimes just literally showing up for someone when someone says, "Look, this is serious for me. Get your ass over here. I need to give you this paperwork. Stop monkeying around with these people and get out of there before you get harmed by your foolishness," is something we'd like to say to some people at some times in our life. But how do you tell someone that you haven't talked to in a long time? How do you give them prophetic wisdom that says, "Look, you're messing with the wrong man right now, and it's going to cause you a hurt that you will never get out of"? How do you let someone know what the Lord is telling you about their life? Now, there's two types of prophetics. There are those who literally get the message of God completely. I have a loving friend named Claudia who literally can stand next to you and tell you everything there is almost to know about your life. And she's pretty darn accurate. She's had that gift since she was a child. It protected her through all kinds of crazy situations in her childhood, much like we've seen in some of the videos talking about children in abused homes, how Jesus is standing right there with them as they're going through and suffering, watching that going on. But literally, that wasn't exactly her situation. But I'm just giving that as the illustration of how that sort of prophetic gift works. Then there's other people who literally have died in some way, lost life in some way. Their silver string has been pulled through them in some way, and they realized they weren't ready to go, or God said, "Not yet." And therefore, they have some gifts. There are other people who study really hard, who submitted all and are gifted. And that might be my situation, hard to say. My gifts are pretty amazing, and I've had those stormtrooper moments when literally I'll get told a phrase, and next minute I know someone's rolling up and saying the precise thing that I was just told minutes before to me. Now that's an amazing story. But who would believe it unless they were standing right there with me listening to what I'm hearing and then hearing and watching it go on? You see, Obi-Wan Kenobi was not so far off in what he could say, that the mind was malleable in simple-minded people. In more analytical people, they get too caught up in their logic to recognize prophetically that they're being told, "Stay away from that individual. They're not safe for you anymore." But openly, there's other people around them who want to control their outcomes in life. There are pastors that want to put certain people together who don't really belong together. There are other people in our communities, in our networking circles, in our professional lives, who want to force couples together who really don't get along in the long-term aspects of creating a life worth living, a retirement worth having, and a loving relationship that will last through the ages of all the stages of cellular degeneration, practically to the point of passing to the Lord's house. Now, isn't that what we're really seeking? Or are we only seeking a good old time with someone who's hot looking that we can show off to our friends and say, "Look what I've got this time"? You see, that's the difference between a person of God and a person who is not of any faith at all. That some people leave churches because pastors abuse their roles in leadership, but other people run from churches because they are told the truth. that they're off track in their life. They have all these serious issues. They try to lay it on someone else because they're not with the right people. If they were spending time with the right person, they wouldn't have half the problems they're in, is absolute truth. If other people were stopped manhandling their lives, that would also improve their outcomes. In my situation, I'm simply looking for a sofa. Now think about this. You approach a church. Openly, the church professes to have 12,000 membership, 6,000 to 7,000 officially per the weekend. And a pastor literally says, I'm sorry, we don't have a sofa in a house in any of our households willing to house a homeless man to keep him from the cold. Let's really think about what that man is saying, that he is Lord of all, that he is the Lord decision maker of all those homes, all those people's lives, and that there is no room in the inn. Isn't that what happened at Jesus' birth? Now, practically, let's talk about another moment in time. I said, look, I don't care if it's a tent. I just need to get out of the wind because two nights ago, I could barely sleep because the wind was so high. No matter how low I laid into the grass, hiding behind my suitcases, underneath my winter blankets, and other things that I practically received from the help of the Lord to know what I would need to stay warm, most of the time, my fingers and my toes remain frigid all night long. And that's the reality. It's 15 below or 15 degrees Celsius or Fahrenheit out there. I can't say precisely because I don't have to. You know what I'm talking about. It is cold. And yet we have pastoral people, literally who represent churches, saying, gosh, I'm so sorry. We have all this property here, all this land, all these electricity units running in the middle of the night to heat and keep the buildings that we practically own warm. But we are not going to allow one single soul to step foot in from the night's cold air, to be out of the elements of winter, to not get frostbite, to not catch their death pneumonia. And openly, we're just not going to do it because of some reason or another. We really have to look at how dehumanizing those statements are by people who represent our organizations. We also have people who literally lie and steal and cheat others out of their life. They destroy their records. They destroy their opportunities. They interfere with them. They give them solitude. They isolate them. They defy the Lord's plan for their life, and they think they're holy. At some point, the people listening, the people mocking my life, are going to get the message. And the Lord is going to hit them with such a ton of bricks that they will never get out of those jail sentences. But openly, that's okay. My life will continue on either here or in the next. But here's what I know 100%. That the one that I love gets the money that I put away for my entire life. Since I was virtually born, I've had a policy. She gets that information. But she has to be willing to get off her butt and get over here and take the information, because it's lawfully rightful for her to know what it is, just in case. That is my lawful decision. They cannot take it from me. Sure, she can deny it, but it's a fool's game to do so. And openly, it's an idiot's errand not to participate in a man's life who loves you that much. Now, this has been Blake Ensign of Blaze Communications LLC, talking about a lot of things. Customer service, love, practicality of life, and how we represent the Lord in every moment of time. The only question is, are we representing His love and His peace and His honor in this world, or are we only providing the people we care about those dignities in the life we live? Thanks for listening.